Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. Today I'm going to be showing you how to create really cool animated outlines around your moving subjects. And the animated outlines can have some really cool glow effects. So for this tutorial, I'm first going to show you how to use the rotobrush tool to separate your moving subject from the background, then how to convert that rotoscope into a mask, and then how to apply a stroke and some glow effects to that outline. Now you can do this effect on any moving subject. It can be a moving car, it can be a skateboarder, it can be a runner, a dancer, anything. The same effects apply. For this clip, I'm using a stock video clip from ArtGrid of this basketball player. If you want to follow along with this clip, I'll put a link to it just down below. And before we jump in, a huge shout out to vidIQ for sponsoring today's video. vidIQ is great for helping me optimize the SEO, the search engine optimization of my videos, so it's more searchable. So if you're interested in trying it out, you can use my link below, and I'll tell you more about how I use it at the end of the video. So let's go ahead and jump on in. So the first step, and the most important step, is to isolate your subject from the background. To do this, we need to use the rotobrush tool. First, make sure we are in the full resolution mode, so that way the rotobrush tool will work better. Then you're going to double click on the clip to open it up to view as a layer. It's important that you view this as a layer or else the rotobrush will not work. Now we're going to press Z on the keyboard to pull up the magnify tool. And then we're just going to click to zoom in on the subject here. Now we can go and click on the rotobrush tool. And here we can then click and quickly draw over the player, and you'll see that the rotobrush tool will start to auto detect the edges. If it selects any unwanted areas, you can press the Alt key on a PC or the Option key on a Mac, and when you select over those areas, it will remove it. So if you need to zoom in farther, just press Z again and you can zoom in closer to the subject so you can better select your subject. And a really cool trick to change the size of the brush tool is if you press the Control key on a PC or the Command key on a Mac, and then click your mouse and move forward, it'll make the diameter of the brush bigger. And if you drag the mouse back, it'll make the diameter smaller. So this can be useful if you're trying to fit into a smaller area of the selection. To zoom back out, you can press Z and the Alt key to see how it looks. And now that this first outline is selected, now press the spacebar to play, and now After Effects will rotoscope the subject out frame by frame automatically. So it does a pretty good job at auto-detecting the outlines as it moves forward in time, but you may have to pause and deselect any unwanted areas with your rotobrush. I'm going to fast forward through the rotobrush analysis until this process is complete. You'll see that I had to do some refinement by the hoop with his hands because the skin tones are very similar to the basketball rim color. So depending on the complexity of your shot and the colors in your shot, it may take more time to complete your rotoscope. So once it's done, we will have our perfect pink outlined roto. And now we can go back to the composition and you'll see that it's just showing the video of him and the basketball. There's no background, it's just transparency in the background. Since we want the background as its own layer, let's go ahead and duplicate this layer here by pressing Command D on a Mac or Control D on a PC. So now from this new duplicated layer, we want to open up the effects and we can actually delete the rotobrush tool effect on this layer. And now the background is back. And with this layer selected, let's also press Enter to rename it to background just for organizational purposes. Now, if you want to turn on the visibility of the background layer, just click on the eye icon to turn it on or off. And let's turn it off for now. So now what we're going to do is we're going to turn this roto layer into a mask. To do that, you're going to go up to Layer and select Auto Trace. From this window, you're going to select the work area in your timeline. It's important here to make sure that you have work area selected because you want to auto trace the entire work area, not just one frame. And for this clip, which is about 7 seconds, it took about 2 minutes to complete the auto tracing. Once it was done, you'll see that the roto was turned into a mask. If we press M on our keyboard, you'll see that it will reveal all of the masks that were created. Because we only need the main outline mask, which is mask number 1, you can delete all the other mask. So what we need to do now is create a new solid layer from which we can copy the mask to. So to copy the mask, make sure your playhead is at the beginning of the timeline. Then press Command X on a Mac or Control X on a PC to cut this first mask. Now go to Layer, New, Solid, and let's make a black solid. And let's be sure to call it something that we'll remember, like Mask and Effects. And then we can paste the mask onto the solid layer by pressing Command V on a Mac or Control V on a PC. So now that the mask is on the solid layer, it's going to serve as the outline for the stroke and glow effects that we will apply to it. Since this is a black solid, let's remove the black by right-clicking on the solid layer and then changing the blend mode to screen to remove the black. And since the rotoscoping is done, we can actually turn off our roto layer just below because it's no longer needed now that we have the mask on the solid layer. And now let's turn back on the background layer. And as we scrub through, you can see that the mask is not lining up with the subject in the video. And that's because I had previously scaled up the background layer to 122% to fit the frame. So all this means is that we have to go to the mask and effects layer, press S on our keyboard to bring up the scale, and let's scale it to 122%, and now it's perfectly aligned. So now let's go ahead and add a stroke effect to the mask. Go to effects and search for stroke. Double click to apply it to our mask and effect solid layer. Now from effect controls, select all mask from this effect, and then you can choose any color that you want for the stroke. Let's try green, and let's increase the size of the stroke. From here, you can go to effects and search for glow, and you can apply the glow effect to the clip. But I actually prefer to use a free plugin effect called Saber by Video Copilot. It's a plugin that you must install while After Effects is closed, but once you reopen it, it'll appear in your effects. So what I'm going to do is double click to apply the Saber effect to the mask and effects layer. Now from effect controls underneath Saber, we need to customize this effect. The first thing we need to do is select the core type and change it to layer mask. So that way the Saber outline will go along the mask outline. And now this is the cool part where you can play around with some of Saber's presets. So for example, you can choose solar to get more of a cool sun effect, or you can try the mist preset for a nice blue ice outline. I'm going to use the Ghostbuster preset. And from here, you can customize the preset however you like. So you can play around with the glow intensity to make it higher or lower. Or if you want to make the outer line smaller or bigger, you can adjust the core size. So now when we play it back, you can see that the outline, the Ghostbuster outline, is around the subject the whole time he is dribbling and going up to the hoop. But what if you want the outline to animate around him and move around him as he's moving? Or let's say you want it to get more intense as he dunks. I'm going to show you how to do that using keyframing. So from the mask and effects layer in the composition, you're going to open up the Saber effect and go down to Customize Core. In here, we are going to animate the start and the end offsets. So to start, let's move the playhead back to the beginning and let's bring the offset down to zero so the effect is not visible. Then let's turn on keyframing by selecting the stopwatch. Now move the playhead forward and let's bring it up to 100%. Now from the start offset, bring the playhead to align with our second keyframe that we just made. Then bring the start offset to zero, and then turn on the stopwatch. Then move forward just a bit and bring it back up to 100%. And now we have this looping motion around the outline as he's moving. And then to repeat it and make it more interesting, I'm just going to lasso and select all of these keyframes, then copy it by hitting Command V or Control V on a PC. And then I'm going to move forward and paste it. And now when we play it back, you can see we have some interesting movement looping around our subject. And at the very end, I'll make one more keyframe so that way the outline will stay as he's going up to dunk. And now when he dunks, the exact moment, if we move to that exact frame, we want the intensity of the core to increase so that way the outline gets thicker and the glow is more strong. So I'm going to turn on the keyframing next to core size. Then I'm going to move one frame over and increase the core size to around 2.5. And then when he lets go, I'm going to move forward and do the exact opposite. I'm going to set the keyframe right before he lets go, and then I'm going to move one frame over and reduce the core size back down to 1. And now at the very end, if we want it to fizzle out the outline to go back to norm, let's go back to the start offset, set a keyframe, then move the playhead forward just a little bit, and then increase this back up to 100 to make the outline disappear as a flicker movement. So you don't have to animate it exactly like I did it. I just wanted to show you that you can use the start and the end offsets to create some cool motion. And this was the final effect I was able to create. So that's all for this effect. And now here's a little bit about today's sponsor, vidIQ. If you're a YouTuber or if you manage a YouTube channel, vidIQ is a great way to help you optimize your videos to make sure it's getting more views. So how does it work? It's actually a Chrome extension that integrates with your YouTube channel. So when I'm logged into my YouTube channel, what I'm able to do is see recommended keywords. And I'm using a boost plan, so it gives me recommended keywords that would help my video get more views. And as I add the keywords, it gives me a score so I can know that I'm getting closer to the optimal 50 out of 50 SEO score. So the closer I get to that score, the better my video will appear in searches. Two more things about vidIQ that I find super useful is one, the thumbnail comparison. So if I'm uploading my thumbnail and I want to see how my thumbnail looks compared to other videos related to my topic, I can then search by a keyword and see what my thumbnail looks like compared to the other competition. So that way I can say, would people actually click on my thumbnail compared to somebody else's video? After all, your YouTube video is like the book cover, right? So it's the first thing that somebody sees before they decide to click. So it's really important to compare to see if it's up to par to the competition. One last thing that's really cool about vidIQ is that you can use it as a research tool. So if you're doing pre-production to figure out what content you want to make, you can use vidIQ to search for trending topics. So that way, maybe you can make content related to a trending topic to get more views, more subscribers, and get more people aware about your channel. So if you're interested in trying out vidIQ, I put a link in my description box below, and let me know if you guys have any questions about it. Thanks, vidIQ, for sponsoring. If this video helped you out, be sure to give it a big thumbs up and also hit that notification bell and subscribe so you guys are notified when I publish new content. That's all for today's video, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!